We'll discuss about the block diagram of 8086 microprocessor or architecture of 8086 microprocessor. So if you see the total unit, it is divided into two functional units called as bus interface unit and execution unit. So dividing the architecture in this manner speeds up the processing. So these two units, they run parallelly. Okay, and coming to the bus interface unit, the main functions of the bus interface unit is to fetch the instructions from the memory. So whenever you want to execute your program, you need to bring that program onto the processor, and your program gets executed instruction by instruction. Okay, so that's why the main function of the bus interface unit is to fetch the instructions from the memory, and it needs to send out the addresses for memory locations, and it needs to send out the addresses for IO devices, and it reads and writes data to memory locations, and it reads and writes data to IO devices. So in some cases processor also wants to access the data from the IO devices. So the main function of the bus interface unit is fetching the instructions from the memory. Okay, and coming to the main components of the bus interface unit, here we have three main components. So the first component is called as segment registers, these four segment registers, and the next one is called as instruction pointer, and the next one is called as the instruction byte queue. Okay, so what is the use of these segment registers? So as you know, memory is outside the processor. So whenever processor wants to access the memory, it makes use of the contents of these registers. So to organize the memory efficiently and to access the memory fastly, memory is divided into four segments. So the names of those segments are nothing but extra segment, code segment, stack segment, and data segment. So whenever processor wants to access the extra segment, it makes use of the contents of this ES. Whenever it wants to access the contents of the code segment, it makes use of the contents of this register. Whenever it wants to access the stack segment, it makes use of the contents of this stack segment register. Whenever it wants to access data segment, it makes use of the contents of this DS register. So each of these registers, they holds the starting address of that particular segment, and instruction pointer holds the address of the current instruction. And coming to this instruction byte queue, so where 8086 microprocessor uses parallel processing, so that means whenever execution unit is executing the current instruction, the buses of the 8086 processor are free. So the bus interface unit uses these buses to prefetch the 6 bytes of the following instructions into this queue. So that means next instructions are prefetched and they are placed in this instruction byte queue. So whenever execution unit finishes executing the current instruction, it reads the next instruction directly from this queue. So it need not wait for the BIU to fetch the next instruction. Okay, so why? Because already the next instruction is placed in this instruction byte queue. So this technique is called as a pipelining technique. So pipelining means fetching the next instruction while current instruction is in execution. This technique is called as pipelining technique. And coming to the execution unit. So the main function of the execution unit is decoding the instruction and executing that instruction. And here, if you see the main components of the execution unit, control system, and inside that instruction decoder is there. And the next one is arithmetic and logic unit, and next one is flag register, and here these are called as general purpose register, and these two are called as pointer registers, and these two are called as index registers. Okay, so coming to the functionality of each and individual unit, so instruction decoder translates the instructions into series of actions which are carried out by the execution unit, and control system generates the control signals which are used for internal operation of the microprocessor. And coming to the arithmetic and logic unit, it is 16-bit unit and it performs arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, and logical operations like increment, decrement, shifting and rotating of the binary numbers. Okay, so it performs all these operations on the operands. Operands are nothing but data. Okay, and flag register is used for holding different signals, controls signals. You can it has different purpose, so we'll discuss later about this flag register, and it indicates the status of the microprocessor. Okay, and coming to the general purpose registers, here these 8 are called as the general purpose registers. They are AHAL, BHBL and CHCL and DHNDL. So these 8 registers are called as general purpose registers, and their size is 8 bit. So you can combinedly use these two registers as one 16 bit register, which is named as AX register. So if you combine these two registers, you can get a BX register, which is 16 bits in length. And if you use the CH and CL combinedly, it is named as a CX register, and DH and DL combinedly, it is a 16-bit DX register. So these are used to store the intermediate values during processing. Okay, and coming to the SP and BP, they are called as pointer registers. So pointer registers, they holds the memory addresses. SP is nothing but stack pointer. So to access the stack, the processor makes use of this stack pointer. So stack pointer points to the top of the stack. Okay, and base pointer is used to store the base address of the stack segment. So SS is the base address of the stack segment, thus that SS contents you can also store in the base pointer registers. And coming to the SI and DI, they are called as index registers. Okay, and they are used in the string operations. Okay, whenever you need to perform string operations, the SI is used for the source string. Okay, SI, source index registers, and DI is used to hold the destination string addresses. So these are the different registers available in the execution unit. So each register is having some specific functionality. So we'll discuss about the register functionalities, specific functionalities in the next class.